kids workshop. It had been a long time, but now we are going to do stuff. As you can see, last time we were building a boat, or we were starting building a boat. I will just take the front of it so you can see what we are doing or where we want to end up. Oops, there. So it should be the easiest build they have, or one of the easy ones. It's a fishing boat and it's a cutter. And the name in Danish translated is seagull. Six, or what is it? 683. So, and that is one of the boats that's kind of from the olden days, you know. They are still around, but years back there were thousands of them. But around the Danish coastline, but now there are only a few back. All the fishing vessels are much larger. So last time we didn't get further than put these in, and you can see I had taken them out of this, broken them out of this board here, and then put them in the holes here. So we are gonna glue that to the this piece here, and in the package there was some glue, and we will use that, but I think that's ordinary white carpenter glue. But what do I know? I will take a piece of paper to open this with, so it don't get messy. I'm a little out of the picture now. And last time I also kind of forgot to show it with this camera, so. But if you are starting on this, then I would mark, write the numbers on these, because when you are 6 here, 5, 7, 4, 8, 3, and 2, and 1, and then they are placed in 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, and 5, and so on. So it's a kind of confusing when the numbers are not on there. They could have painted the numbers on, but they didn't. So now I have done it because I started doing it a little wrong last time. So we'll cut this one and see if we can get some. Oh, oops! We would. And we'll get a towel here somewhere. That was not the plan. And outside the paper too. So and somewhere on the tube on the container there stand shake it before use. Yes. But I did, but that was this one. And there are two. So we will do that now. Hey, that is some thin running stuff. Stand up against this one. Take your neutral. I think I prefer to use my own glue, but now you try to use this. So, first one, and I will glue it a little on the sides here. Not too much, on both sides. And go away. Oh, maybe I will put a little on this part. They put a ton of water in it. I don't like that. So, and then I don't want my I don't like it. I think it's because then they can make a lot of it to no money. Water is cheap. See, now I will do like this. And see if I can get a, not this one, but maybe this one. No, I cannot, but I would like to have some pressure on it. We will hold it a little while. So, hope it works. And the next one. But do place them first before you start to glue, so that you are sure that and you don't glue the wrong one in. The wrong one in the wrong place. Because even there is a lot of water in this. I expect it when it first are dry, it's difficult to get it apart without destroying it. But if you have seen some of the other things I do, the break, that's also a boat. And, oops, it's because that's a boat I built many, many, many years ago that has been thrown around on attics and cellars and where not. And kind of gotten a little rough around the corners, so we are kind of restoring it, but what I wanted to say is that it will not always be about boats. It's just because I saw this one and it was kind of cheap. It's and easy to make and fun to make, I think. But as you know, we have made a trebuchet and a catapult and a Minecraft wolf and whatnot. We have made a lot of different stuff, even jewelry we have made. And we will meet. But you're always welcome to come with good suggestions. And it has to be kind of cheap so everyone can be a part of it. And this boat is a type you can get all over the world. It's a billing boat, the name of the factory is. And they have a lot of big frigates and stuff like that. Sailboat, motorboats, and some of them, or nearly all of them, you can steer with radio and so on. But then it starts to get expensive. But you can always start and try with these little ones. They even have the, I don't know if any one of you have seen that film, but an old film with Humphrey Bogart with, I think it was the Africa Queen, the boat. The name of the boat was, but I don't guess you have seen that. There are a lot of big galleons like and warships. The one I'm restoring in Brig is a frigate, Jutland, and that is a warship. With both sails and steam engine. And a little bit. little bit there. And the last one of these. I don't know the English word for it, but in my language, the name of these is Spender. I should have looked it up before. And it was also the meaning, but then we had to install drivers and stuff. And that was certainly not the plan. So, then, see? That was not that tough. But be a little, what should we say, careful and do the best you can, because it's gonna bite you later on when you build things like this if it don't fit right. If this. You need this space here because when you put the wood on the side here, it's kind of have to have this lip here to lay on. Or so be a little bit. Now we will let this. See, the plan is that it kind of, this one is built in two half parts. You can see here, this is at one half part, and you can see these parts are connected afterwards. So you kind of build one first, and then you build the other one, and then you glue them together. And then you start building, see, then you have this, and then you start building all the stuff on top, the hut, or the, I don't know what you call that, but Kevin, the wheelhouse, I think. The name is. So, but you can see this is cut out, laser cut, and if you look very careful, then they are kind of it's kind of cut there, and there there's connection between the two pieces, and then here is the connection, and here so it stands together. So instead of just start to break, you probably can, and then you also risk breaking some stuff off. So all these bridges there are between, can you see what I'm doing? Yes, all the bridges there are between, I will cut with a knife. This type of knife, or this is a scalpel, but you can also use a hobby knife or whatever. I'll guess it that you need a hobby knife if you are doing stuff like this. Get down there. You don't need a lot of tools, but a hobby knife and whatever. What else? I mean, there'll be a lot of sanding on it, so something that you can sandpaper. Oops. Now we are making a new. There are only a few of these small bridges. And I have used a scalpel all my life, like, it's a really, really good tool to have. A really scalpel, like the doctor is using, like the surgeons are using. It's a good thing to spend money on. Everyone should have one. Oops. There's a bridge somewhere I haven't seen. Oh no. Oh yes, oh no. Because you buy new blades. Oops. You buy new blades to it so you can. But be careful, it's sharp. But this is not done with this, it's done with the scissors. I tried to see if I could cut my fingers. See? Now we have one more. And we will lay that aside for a minute. And then we'll take these. Because that's the hold to those. See, there is only one I can see. So away, and here is also only one bridge. At least what I can see. And one more. Go away. But you can see it's not that difficult. So now we have two, and we'll still let this one dry, and we'll go back, and start with number one in this end, and we'll put this one over there. Number one is this one here. Oh, we haven't gotten it out yet. Cut it out. Oh, No, I don't want to go to this. Yep. Oh, number two we have here. Where is it? Now, gonna give or take. You can see, obviously, there was one more down here. And that's what happens when you don't do right. See, this one, and number two, here, and number three, where are you? You're here. Okay, it is already free and loose. Down here, please. See? And number four, you can see it's placed all over the, because this way they can have more on the same piece of the wood. I think it is free now. It is. Number four. Then we need number five. It's up here. See, it's easier when you have marked them. And this I have written. So we don't make any mistakes. All right. And number six. Yeah. And number seven, because they have to follow, you know, the form, shape of the boat. If you place them wrong, then you cannot get the what are we calling that? Okay. Now, eight. The outer shield, or what we shall call it, to fit. Nine. And never meet in front of the knife, said the man with a bandage. But you know what I mean. Because then you get blood all over the stuff. And that don't look nice. And number 10, Downing Street. Or somewhere there about, oops. Because you will lose control over the knife. Once a while, when you put some strings in it, and then if you have the thumbs behind it, then we have troubles. any of you know how boring it is to sit down on an emergency. There's a lot of... This is not burned off. So now it's this is funny. So number 10. See? And then that is to something else. Then we need you can see, I put this over here. Then we need a piece like this and a piece like this. And as far as I can see, then I have one piece like this here. And I need one piece like this here. So this we will put aside. And see if we can cut this without fighting like crazy. So that was that. That there's two here. One. And two. And here's one little bridge. And here's one too. So to the front, and this little one to the back of the boat. Is there more? No. It's like this. See? So. Glue, 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 and we will take our building board that was included in the package. So I guess they wanted us to use it for this. But we will put this little thing on. I'm not loving those. And you can see cotton sticks. They are also very usable. Is you and they kind of parallel with each other somewhat. So, and then we take the front too while we are at it. So. sure that it fits. It's not, these cuttings are not 200%. They are more like 99 or 95. So oop. Don't. Cannot find the hole. Here it was. Oops. And but I hope you guys have some good ideas to what, if you come up with the ideas, then you're certain that it's not only my stuff we are building, what I like, but what you like. Then it's funnier to do. I know a lot of kids around want to make something with a Raspberry Pi or something computer-like, but that we could do that, but there are so many that do that, but not many that do this, I think, because I think it's important also to know how things are built or made, even I know it cannot compete with Minecraft, but Minecraft is kind of sometimes also how things are built, but it is in a virtual world. This is a really world, and many of you will make something with computers and stuff like that. And you can see this is cut out with the laser cutter and put in a computer first, in a computer program. So, of course, but if you want to build something, You have to do it with your hands. And you can make some pretty amazing thing with your hands. So. And in these years, everybody in the whole world are fixating on making computer stuff, being coder and making computer programs or making apps or whatever. But when the whole world have educated themselves to do that, then there need to be somebody to make real stuff to them. And that can be you. And of course not model ships or, but I promise you, you learn something by using tools and, but enough of that. Old man's rant. And it because I want you to have the same satisfaction making good stuff like I have. I love to make stuff like this, and I have done it tons of times. So it's stiff. So you see now, that's why I don't like there's so much water in it. You can see then it started to bend and so on. But That's what happens. But as I can see, we don't get much more done tonight because I have used an hour of your time. And but next time we will put, and next time first next Tuesday, we will put some sides on it, and then maybe I will do a little on forehand so that we don't spend all night. But I will only do one side because you have to see because that's kind of the little difficult part. See, now we have, you can see, it's also here, I have cut it in the, on forehand, but you can see it's a deck here. And then we can put the deck on here. Yeah, we can do it like this. See, and then when we bend it a little. And by the way, look at the look what side is nicest to look at, all right? And then you do like this, and then you put it on the, see, that's why it's important that we kind of get it to fit. think. And then we glue that on, and then we need something on top of that one. And the hole for the mast. There is a little mast on the corner, but you can see, but I will stop and let this dry so it don't go apart for tomorrow. So I will say bye-bye and thank you for watching, and hope I will see you next Tuesday.